But we see a massive capitalization on that one. Take them off stage, go for the conversions, chase them off stage, keep getting more buffs, keep track of your mana and all that sort of thing. And that's what you need to do with a character like that that needs something to get going. And speaking of get going, we're going to go into game one of Vivi versus... I'm not sure who this is in the second one.
Yeah, we got Vivi on deck with the Lucario. This is a character that has fallen by the wayside for a lot of people, especially because they don't have the best options overall. But when it comes to Lucario, you have that KO comeback factor. Wolf, though, the consistency of anti-fun. This character is so good at doing things like that Nair, Fair, and also just shutting down a lot of the lower range mid-tier characters. Mm-hmm. And you just keep that pressure up. You keep them in a position where they never feel comfortable because of tech chases like that. And LRA start, excellent start to the game, the beginning of this game.
Yep, very aggressive from LRA start on that one. I'm just gonna go with start.
Wait, doesn't that mean quit or reset? Because that's literally actually or menu. That's like
That's the no contest.
Yeah. All right. So we're gonna call him no contest. I mean, right now it's no contest. Then you got the lead at least.
Yep. But see, the thing is about this is that Lucario has such an odd relationship with, you know, normally it's like, oh, you know, I'm behind. I might benefit from late rage.
Yeah. Odd relationship with losing. Because
Lucario is never, ever, ever out of the game.
Yeah.
Not ever.
100%. I saw somebody say this on Twitter not that long ago, where they said Lucario's strength is bracket fear, because when you're in bracket, you get scared of the potential of dying at 30, as everybody should. But when you're in a situation where pressure's not on, you're more likely to camp that Lucario than you would in a situation where you're forced to find the KO.
Mm-hmm. And we're seeing a lot of neutral dominance here from start, trying to, you know, just doing a lot of what things, repping the forward air, the nair, the back air, all very strong options on this one. Lucario, very strong options on shield. The hitboxes maybe aren't enough to contest with Wolf's here, and very good projectile on his blaster as well.
Yeah, speaking of projectiles too, like you would think, you know, Refractor on deck might be scary, but Lucario uses that Aura Sphere as a KO combo tool too. So you can't just comfortably respect the idea, oh, I'm fine. No, you have to always be worried that you might just get wave landed on or wave bounced on with that Aura Sphere. Right now, this is an even game.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and we see those right there. Air dodges out of the combo, very nice. 144%, this is still scary because now Aura is on deck and Wolf is not that heavy.
Oh my god, that would have been like a solid 20%+. Now you're forced to deal with this edge trap.
Okay,
oh, back
here
off the platform though.
Yep, Vivi going for the commitment there, thinking they've got start nailed down, but start taking to the air and going in for the back air. Very nice security kill.
Yeah, I like the way that start is playing too, because a lot of times when people see Lucario at those KO percents, you get a little bit obvious with your like your approach for a KO. You want to find that grab, you want to find a reckless dash attack. But no, he's actually been doing a good job of kind of hopping around, forcing Vivi to pull the trigger first to find it.
Mm-hmm. And Wolf honestly can play a game of very little commitments on that one. Juggle there from Vivi, a little bit of a tough spot, because even though Wolf has a decent fall speed, not a whole lot of options to hit directly with Wolf. But Wolf has a lot of very non-committal options, the Nair, the Fair, very good tilts. So you can play a little bit of a slower game on that one. The projectile is not going to have as much going for it. Actually, good shield on that one and good reflector, honestly. That was very present.
Yeah, that was smart mental awareness from Vivi. Like, you're that far away from the reflector character. Just put shield up potentially, because why go try to push when you could just get your damage and run with it? This even game right now, though, tries to call a hard read air dodge down and in. That's your jump once again. Gretz is looking. Never mind, not so scary. I did not expect that aggressive up either.
Yeah. That looked like it was going for ledge. That was pretty ambiguous on that one, I would say. All right, air dodge. All right, this is looking
pretty scary.
It
should be at the scary ledge. Oh, it gets by with the neutral get up. Yeah. That's so frightening to just get up in front of.
Vivi just keeps falling. It's like, no, I'm over here. Oh. I'm chasing you. He's actually dead.
That is some buffs coming through, because that side B got a very slight change, a shadow buff, to getting an easier, consistent grab. You will see in that spot sometimes it will miss. It'll go for the hitbox instead. So LRA start might have been fine, but I can't wait to see, like, when we get back to it, because I want to see how close that was. Either way, though, you see how much larger that side B is now, too? Like, that is still a scary spot at KO percents.
Very scary. Honestly, very quick, too. So by the time you get hit by it, you're like, wait, this is a command grab, right? Mm-hmm.
Die. That's it. Fair trade. You get grabbed. I win. All right, we're getting into the next game. Switch off to the green color here. Apparently, Pokemon players are all about playing green today. Running it back to, how are you feeling about the way, you know, we saw a lot of good things out of LRA starting that first game, but what are you feeling about the changes that might need to happen to keep that lead we saw that was working before?
You know, honestly, what we're looking at right now, I think the way LRA Star was playing it was already pretty good. It was just a couple of situations there where Vivi was able to get in. I think they could maybe play it a little bit slower and look for some more whip punishes on this one, but... You know, we'll have to see. There's going to be a lot of adaptation for both, and Vivi very good with the movement with Lucario using the Aura Sphere. So if you play a little too whip punishy, then Lucario might get in your face.
Oh my god. And that was all of, like, one of the things I was going to point out for LRA Start is that the ledge trapping hasn't been so consistent. We've seen ledge traps, the down smash from that first KO, and a bunch of other stuff off these jump calls, but so far, it is just getting bodied now. All these jump calls and air dodge reads forced amazing. But if LRA Start does not finish his food at ledge, he's going to keep holding these outs like the way he is right now. Now he's going to be forced to take another one. That could be a stock. Oh, my God.
Call out on the air dodge. Very nice. Very scary place to be in because it's like, oh, no, this is where the Lucario conversion comes in. So you got to do something. Yep. And we're seeing a good rep of the down air out of shield as well. Very quick, leads to some very good situations for Lucario.
Oh my goodness, that, all right, finally catching the up air, but right now, Scope Lens is equipped to Lucario. Like, Vivi has the key to every single hit, and like now forcing pressure, yep, you keep that up, gets the follow-up too, tries to read a jump away from that dash attack, but look at this pressure from
Vivi. Yeah, he's going incredibly aggressive on this one, compared to the first game where it's like, oh, you know, man, starts really holding control here, there's
jump
a lot of respect
call
from Vivi.
Gretch, that's it. Sometimes it'd be like that. I was going to say I'm very worried about LRA Start's potential of getting by the ledge trap after we've seen what happens, but sometimes you just give it to him in a gift basket. That was so well played by Vivi. After that first game looked kind of rough, but yeah. Second game, not so much.
See, the thing is, right, is that Vivi did still pull out that first game, and I think there's a lot that can be said for trying to feel out the neutral on that game one. Because against Woof, very powerful character, a lot of options. We saw early on that tech chase into the down smash.